Hello, this is Madam Koo, and today we are going to look at work done. Today we are going to look at work done. So work done by a constant force is given by the product of the force and the distance moved in the direction of the force. Okay, key thing here, you must remember, it must be moved in the direction of the force. So from this definition, we can see that the formula is, okay, this one, work done is equals to force, and that is a constant force, times the distance moved in the direction of the force. So this is work done, and the unit is in joule. A force is in Newton and distance is in meter. So these are the SI unit for work done, force and distance. Let's take a look at some example. Okay, if there's a box on the floor and a person is pushing it, and the box moves. Alright, so the force exerted by this person on the box, in the end, the distance move in the direction of the box. Multiply them and you will get the work done. The key thing is in the direction. What do you mean by in the direction, and what if it's not in the direction? So for example, this is in the direction of the force, but if the person is holding a tray with a cup and walking. If a person is holding a tray with a cup and walking forward, the force exerted on the cup is upwards, acting against the weight of the cup, which is downwards towards gravity. So since the force that is acting on this cup is not in the direction of the motion, there is no work done on this cup when this person is holding it stationary on the hand and moving forward. However, if this person is walking up the stairs, then there will be work done against gravity. So it will be in the direction of the force. Another example, if this is a wall and someone is pushing on it, imagine you are pushing very hard against this wall. However, the wall does not move. So is there work done on the wall? No, there isn't, because there is no distance moved by the wall at all. The distance will be zero in this case because it has not moved at all. So in this case, the work done is zero. So let's see one example. This person is pushing the box in this direction. He's using a 45 Newton force and push it from point A to point B, which is 3 meters away. A 45 Newton force is applied to the box and it moves from point A to B, which is 3 meters apart. So calculate the work done. What is the work done here? The work done here is force times distance moved in the direction of the force, and it is 45 Newton times 3 meters. So what's the answer? It is 135 joule. So I hope after watching this video, you have a better idea of what work done is. Work done by a constant force. Constant force here is given by the product of the force and the distance moved in the direction of the force. So if you are pushing it this way, there should be a distance moved in this direction. And if you are pushing it this way, it should move in this direction. If you are exerting a force on an object but not moving in the same direction of the force you are exerting, there will be no work done on that object. And if there's no movement at all, the distance moved in the direction of the force is zero, so there will be no work done. And remember that the SI unit for work done is joules, and you always calculate using the SI unit of force and distance, that is in Newton and meter. Revise your topic well, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye-bye.